Okay, good afternoon, class 12th, and welcome to our today's virtual class. Today we are continuing with the same chapter, that is physiology and injuries in sports. But today we are having the next topic in the same chapter. The name of the today's topic is physiological factor determining endurance. Clear? In the previous virtual class, we are completing the two components of fitness relating with the physiological factor. Number one is speed and second one is strength. So students, come to the today's topic, that is physiological factors determining endurance. First of all, a brief introduction regarding the endurance. We can define endurance as the ability to perform cardiovascular exercises like running, aerobic exercises or swimming for an extended period of time. Endurance, basic meaning of endurance is resistance against the activity for a longer duration. Clear? And the exercises, cardiovascular exercises, for example, running, aerobic exercise or swimming for an extended period of time. Here, in this particular component of physical fitness, the duration of the exercises is longer. Clear? Endurance exercise is characterized by one simple requirement, the necessity to sustain repeated muscles contraction. Mean to say, because here in this particular component of fitness in endurance, the time of the physical activity or the exercise is longer. So, for that particular longer duration, the repetitive muscles contraction will be there, and due to this particular repetitive muscular contraction, due to the longer time for the exercises or the physical activities, we require the proper or adequate supply of the energy. Clear? This criterion is fulfilled through two basic functions. Ye jo criteria hai, to fulfill to this particular criteria, through we are having only two basic functions. The ability to consume enough oxygen and adequate fuel provision, this is first basic criteria. Two, ability to consume enough oxygen, the body, the capacity or the ability of body to consume maximum oxygen, and due to this particular process, then adequate fuel provision or fuel supply to the muscle for the proper contraction. Clear? The capacity for oxygen consumption is reliant upon the physiological parameters of maximal oxygen uptake, lactate threshold and economy of the movement. This is the second function regarding to regarding to resist against the longer duration. First one is, that is consume enough oxygen and adequate fuel provision. Second one is capacity for oxygen consumption is reliant upon the physiological parameters. Number one is maximal oxygen uptake, VO2 volume, jisko hum bolte hain VO2 volume, maximum oxygen uptake. Second one is lactate threshold. Lactate threshold means when the body indulges in a longer physical activity or longer physical exercises, after some time the amount of lactic acid is increasing in the body, and due to that particular increasing of lactic acid in body, the contraction ability of muscles is decreasing, and due to that particular situation, the body will not continue with the longer duration exercises. But in lactate threshold, it is the ability of human body that in the presence of lactic acid also body is able to continue with the exercises. And the third one is economy of movement. Economy of movement means when the body is able to perform the movements or perform the physical activities in a proper adequate manner or the technique, then the wastage of energy is not over here if the movement is in a proper economy. So these are the two basic functions which is related to endurance. Now after this particular thing, we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 physiological factors determining endurance. Number one is muscle composition. It is basically related with red muscle fibers and the white muscle fibers. In endurance, we required the maximum percentage of red muscle fibers because their ability, the red muscle fibers are having the ability to release the energy in a slow manner and for a longer duration, which is purely based on the endurance activities or endurance ability, we required the such kind of muscles composition, especially of red muscles fiber, or you can say the slow twitch muscle fiber. In a study, it is clear, it is proved that maximum marathoners, those who are performing the marathon races,
In their legs, 90% muscle composition is of red muscle fiber. Second one is lactic acid tolerance. This is related to lactate threshold. मैंने जो आपको पहले बताया that when the body is continuing with the longer exercises or longer duration activities, then there is a condition comes in the human body that the increasing in the level of lactic acid. Due to this particular increasing level of lactic acid, it shows that now body is not able to continue with the exercises. But by the training or by the few exercises, we are able to create or develop this particular technique that is known as lactic acid tolerance. That in the presence of lactic acid also, or we can say that in an anaerobic environment also, the body is able to perform for the longer duration. Movement economy, I'll already explain. Movement economy means the skills, the movements, or the movements which is done by the body that should be in a proper technique and proper manner. Meaning to say, if we are not performing our movements in a proper technique, that is relevant, that is totally related to the wastage of energy. Aerobic capacity. Aerobic capacity means, aerobic means in presence of oxygen. Meaning to say, in this particular environment, the maximum adequate supply of oxygen is given to the body. And due to this particular situation, the here we have point, where is that external period? Where is that? This. If the aerobic capacity is okay of the body, then the enough consuming of oxygen and adequate fuel provision for the muscles contraction. So this is aerobic capacity. But this aerobic capacity is based on these particular two points. Number one is oxygen intake capacity and oxygen transport. Oxygen intake capacity is directly depends upon the ability of your lungs, size of alveoles, numbers of alveoles, size of lungs, each and everything. Mean to say, if the lungs are not able to intake the maximum oxygen, then the body is not able to work in a proper manner. Clear? Second one is oxygen transport. After intaking the maximum or the adequate amount of oxygen in the body, how this oxygen is transported to the lungs, to the heart, to fuse with this particular blood to create a proper oxygenated blood. So these are the few physiological factors determining endurance. Clear?